Following the liberalization, India registered the lowest electronics per capita consumption. Today, our country is one of the two net foreign exchange losers in the global region. Our contribution to the world trade of electronics and instrumentation stands at around 1.3%, while the Asia accounts for about 52%. Clearly, we missed the ticket to ride on the Asian electronic boom. This is because all the incentives that were given to the SEZs, hardware parks, and the tax exemptions yielded no tangible results and did nothing to promote innovation or manufacturing. Who do we blame for the state of affairs? This brings us to two questions. Why do we have to carefully examine the past? What is the relevance to the present? In the present seminar and panel discussion, it is expected that we take stock of these moot questions and see how India can extricate itself from the present deep rut. One of the obvious reasons for the sad state of affairs is improper policy implementation and follow-up by the professionals. We must ensure that the emerging policies are not again misused by the industry, allowing other peoples to take soft option of trading instead of innovation. Let us look at some of the present policies that are expected to enhance the manufacturing base. 1. Allowing higher FDI in several vital sectors. Will they bring the latest technologies? Will they simultaneously work with our R&D for the next generation versions? Do we go through the same cycle of phased manufacturing, leading to just import of entire systems, then importing in the CKD condition, and so on, by which time the user wants the latest model and these are imported again in full? What is the monitoring mechanism that should be used to see that we have full design knowledge, intellectual property for advanced versions? If it does not happen, as it did not in the past, we only manage to secure a labor contract. We reap the fruits of our sweat, but not those of our own intellect. For sustained development, we have to focus on innovation. Can we achieve this by expanding FDI? 2. Encouraging venture funds, incubators, and startups. In the present scenario, more than 90% of the startups are software oriented to improve services and do not significantly contribute to Make in India. For the hardware startups, what is the criteria to select a product? Does the market demand dictate it? Or is it the fancy of the product? What kind of people are in the startup business? Are they people without jobs? Are they people encouraged by a business lobby that simply wants to take advantage of the tax incentives and income tax exemptions? Are there any guidelines? Does the government assure the market for such products which are developed by the startups against the imports? It's a long journey from the prototype stage to a saleable product. Will the designer hold the hands of the manufacturer till the end of the cycle of the time of the product? Do the educational institutes have the necessary expertise to really guide and mentor in bringing out state-of-art products? What are the mechanisms to ensure reasonable success in bringing out globally acceptable products out of these efforts? The third one is the skill centers and hubs. Mechanisms to evaluate the output of these centers is very important. And the story does not end with startup publicity.